Part of Abdel Baser Wasigi's courage is that he is going ahead and gutting it out for the finish almost an hour and a half after the last previous finisher in the marathon, and that in itself takes some nerve. And as we mentioned, he has run a 2-hour, 28-minute marathon, fully credited, Jim, for that in Hamburg, Germany. Yes, Brian.
Jim, I think what's also significant here is the spirit of everybody who's put on these games that would allow him to finish in the stadium. Initially, they weren't going to let the stragglers finish. They had started the closing ceremonies. The track was actually covered with the tarp. They came out, uncovered the track. They respect this man for what he's doing. They're going to let him finish. And I think that's wonderful because, you know, we always give lip service to what the great Baron Pierre de Courtaubin said. It's to take part in the Olympics. It's not to win or lose. And this is really it. And I think it really shows all the organizers, all the volunteers have decided, hey, we can volunteer to take the tarp off this track to allow this man to finish.
Well, here he comes, and it is indeed going to be the slowest recorded finish in the history of the marathon.
But he didn't drop out.
One of the innumerable shows of courage here in Atlanta, as Abdel Baser Wasigi, 21 years old from Afghanistan, finishes in 4 hours, 24 minutes, 17 seconds, and for the first time in what we hope is a continuing career as a distance runner, completes the Olympic marathon. We've had the privilege of discussing this with Frank Shorter, gold medalist 1972, silver medalist 1976. There was a lot of concern about the heat here, Frank, but 111 runners did finish the marathon. That in itself is an encouraging statistic. One final brief comment from you before we go.